もし黒い角が生えてて全身からヤバそうなオーラが出てる天使に会ったら、エクシアは君のことを忘れてないよって伝えといてほしいな。
In this interaction, Exia is referring to Mustima, who was once a Laterano citizen just like her. Much of the story today revolves around Mustima, why she has horns and a tail, and why she is still alive.
ドクター、堕天使がどういうものか少しは知ってるみたいだけど、残念ながら私から詳しいことは話せないよ。たとえいつの日か君と全てを分かち合える日が来たとしても、これは私の唯一の秘密さ。
All Sancta are overseen by the Laterano Notarial Hall, which guarantees the rights and benefits of Laterano citizenship. The character who enforces these laws are known as executors. Hence why we have an operator with the codename Executor. From Executor's second archive,We can see some of the recent tasks he accomplished for the Notarial Hall. And I quote, October 12th, the designated property was delivered to the appropriate heir. March 5th, the company that violated the notarized contract was punished. June 2, money was dispersed by the appropriate party in accordance with the contract. July 9, in accordance with the wishes of the citizens, ... These tasks may seem normal, but upon closer inspection, each of these tasks involves a gruesome means to accomplish it. 41 non-Laterano citizens died in the course of executing the first item, while 6 civilian buildings were damaged in the execution of the second item. The third item saw the death of a Laterano citizen serving as the chief executive of a city-state guard unit.And the fourth item nearly cost a war.
ロドスにも銃を扱うサンクタ人はいるようですが、私とは違います。彼らは禁止令により同族に銃口を向けませんが、私は必要とあれば、相手が同族であってもためらわずに引き金を引きます。
Laterano takes its responsibility to its citizens very seriously, treating them as binding contracts.These laws are not the same as normal laws, and they have a higher order which we non-Sancta cannot perceive. One of the 13 clauses in the Laterano Constitution prevents Laterano citizens from pointing a gun at other Laterano citizens. Keep in mind that all Laterano citizens carry some type of range weapon for protection. Executor also mentions that these statutes take effect once a shot is fired.Leaving some to speculate that the 13 clauses are something like a binding originium arts, punishing the offender as soon as they violate it. Executors are sent out to carry out the will of the notarial hall, so Sancta are often very wary when they see an executor nearby.
あれ、あいつもしかして交渉人役場の？面倒いから先に言っとくけど。ラテラーノの秘密なんかこれっぽっちも知らないから、私は何も考えずにぼーっと生きてたいだけ。悠々自適って言うんだっけか。いろいろ知りすぎていいことなんてない。わかるっしょ。
Now that we know a bit more about the Notarial Hall, let's delve into the story between Exia and Mustima. Mustima is one of the more powerful entities in Arknights. Her nickname is the Fallen AngelAnd Dr. Calcet describes her power as unfathomable, saying that if she puts more effort into her test, Rhode Island's training facility would be destroyed. Before the Code of Brawl, the last time Mustima and Exia saw each other was 4 years and 3 months ago. Exia was looking for Mustima, but since Mustima had a habit of not staying in one place, Exia would barely miss her. Quoting from Exia, "What about you?Where did you go? Do you know what it feels like when I met the boss and he said you already left Longman? Like tripping before the finish line." Because Exia hasn't seen Mustima in over 4 years, she had a lot of questions, and I quote from Mustima, "Like the thing about Laterano? Or your sister? Or my horns? Alright, I'll tell you about them, but not right now. You've done a lot of digging, right? You should understand."During this conversation, only 3 operators were present: Exia, Mustima, and Phoenix. Right after the conversation from Mustima and Exia, Phoenix said, "I don't care about her or her sister, but you need to stop her from investigating those things further, or she will get into unnecessary trouble. I am your overseer, and you should be aware of this." During the same event, Mustima also mentions that Exia and her sister are not blood related, but before Mustima could say anything else, Phoenix interrupted her. "Stop! Don't talk about her sister anymore. Even if Laterano doesn't mind, it's not something that you can use for chit-chat. You're here now because you pointed a gun at the squad leader. Or are you really planning to tell her everything someday? The little sister of your best comrade. I have the duty to remind you. Don't say a word about what happened in Kazdo." So now we know that Phoenix, Mustima, and Exia's sister were from the same squad in Kazdo. Keep in mind that this is the place where most Sarkas live. Keep also in mind that Phoenix and Mustima are still connected to the Laterano Hall. Phoenix was a Liberi citizen, but from Laterano, and she worked for the Notarial Hall. So let's go over Mustima's offense. Mustima pointed a gun at Exia's sister, breaking the Laterano Constitution. I believe that breaking the Laterano Constitution revokes one's privilege to use a gun, since this was originally a right granted by the Notarial Hall. If you guys are wondering, Laterano was the first race to discover guns, and it's also a symbol for them. Laterano citizens, specifically the Sancta, can only wield guns once they have completed the Laterano Firearms Usage Agreement. But this is just the beginning. Obviously, losing the right to wield a gun is too light a punishment for breaking a taboo. The Notarial Hall is very, very strict and has several executors to enforce its constitution. Remember that executor killed a Laterano citizen who was a high-ranking public official just for violating a contract with another Laterano citizen. This contract largely involved money, and it was less serious than Mustima shooting another Sancta. So why is Mustima still alive? It is because she's too strong for the Notarial Hall to kill? Or is this always why she's moving from one place to another? Both assumptions are incorrect. In order to understand the situation, we need to look at Mastema, a demon from the Book of Jubilee. He was an angel who tempts humans and tested their faith. He started as an angel, but later on became a fallen angel, just like Mustima. Mustima was able to save 1/10 of the demon race by convincing God to spare them. Why is this relevant to the story in Arknights? Mustima is involved with Laterano. The squad Mustima, Phoenix, and Exia's sister was in was most likely the Mustima. We can speculate this because both Phoenix and Mustima have logos which read Laterano Mustima. It seems that for one reason or the other, the Notarial Hall still needed Mustima, and the mission of the Mustima was probably extremely confidential, which is why Phoenix always kept warning Mustima that Exia would get in trouble if she dug more about this incident. Mustima also tells Exia, and I quote, "Alright, I'll tell you, but not right now. You've done a lot of digging, right? You should understand." Perhaps the compromise for breaking the constitution was to punish Mustima by giving her a trait of those she wanted to save, the Sarkas. This would explain why Mustima is the only one being monitored and no action to execute her has ever been taken. But why wasn't she exempt from the constitution in the same way the executors were? She worked under the Notarial Hall, right? Well, I personally believe that this has to do with the confidentiality of the Mustima squad. Keep in mind that this incident happened during the civil war in Kazdo, meaning there were likely other squads besides the Mustima squad who were involved in that war. There could have been others who saw the event, and we also have to remember that the Laterano Constitution, as mentioned by Executor, immediately take effect once a violation is committed. So even if Mustima didn't do anything wrong, she would have been punished by an automatic repercussion system set for all non-executor citizens. That's it for this video, guys, and I hope you enjoyed. If you want to access the lore videos early, make sure to join my channel. The extra support goes a long way in helping me create more and more content, and the channel membership also do include other perks such as custom badge and rough scenes, so make sure to check those out. I would also like to mention that these type of videos do involve a degree of theory crafting, so the story could change when more information is released in Arknights. Which lore video should we cover next? Make sure to comment below, since I always pick out my stories from the comment.